Good morning once again. In the last class we have done exercise 6.4. Now we have to discuss Pythagoras theorem. Before Pythagoras theorem, I have started the recording. It is already, yes, recording is started. So before that, we need to understand what are squares and square roots, because these squares and square root will be utilized in the Pythagoras theorem. So square means very simple, square of 3. Suppose I am taking square of 3, that means we write like this: 3 power 2. This is power. 3 power 2 means it is not same as 3 into 2. They two are not equal. Class, try to understand. 3 power 2 and 3 into 2 are very different. It's okay, Bani. Class, 3 power 2 and 3 into 2 are very different terms. 3 power 2 means 3 multiplied how many times? 2 times. That is 3 into 3. And the answer is 9. Beta, it is square, that's why. Lavya, uska naam hi square hai. Hai na? Similarly, take suppose 5 square. Tell me the answer of 5 square. It is 5 multiplied 2 times, that is 5 into 5, and the answer is 25. Tell me the answer of 12 square. Answer of 12 square. Oh my God, Ashmit. What Ashmit is doing is, he is doing 12 into 2. Is it correct? Ashmit, tell beta, is it correct? 12 power 2 means 12 into 2. No, they are different things. 12 power 2 means 12 multiplied 2 times. That is 12 into 12. Answer is 144. This was squares. Just for your knowledge, I gave you a hint of cubes also. What is a cube? Cube means power 3. So if I find 3 cube, what is the answer? If I find 3 cube, what is the answer? Class? Yes, it will be 3 multiplied 3 times. And the answer is 27. Tell me what is 2 cube? What is 2 cube? 2 multiplied 3 times. That is 2 into 2 into 2. Answer is 8. So you have to observe, this is the power. Similarly, if I want to find 5 cube, what is the answer? Class, if I try to find 5 cube, what is the answer? Lavya, no beta. Ashmit, no. Daksh, good. Ashmit, again beta, wrong. Try to check your answer. Very good. We have, no Tushita, 5 into 5 into 5. 5 fives are 25. And 25 fives are 125. Yes, this is 5 cube, not 75. Okay, very good. Now almost everyone is clear with the concept of squares. This cubes is extra. This concept will not use right now. Just I gave it for idea. No, Ashima. Who told you this thing? That number should be less than 50. No such case is there. Yes, power will remain same beta. Now, we will see the concept of square root. Square root. It is the reverse process. It is the reverse process. Yes, beta. In cube, power is 3. No, beta Mervin, not a new chapter. Last exercise we are doing. Please see, we have seen that 4 cube is how much? Sorry, why cube I'm taking? We have to be square only, na? Tell me what is 4 square, class? Tell me what is 4 square? Lavya, please check. What is 4 square? Very good, it is 16. Can you tell me what is under root 16? Class, can you tell me what is under root 16? Very good, it is a reverse process. Answer is 4. Now the question comes, how I got the answer? We have to prime factorize this number. Prime factorize this number. So we have got 16, 2 8s are, 2 4s are, 2 2s are, and 2 1s are. So we can write the 16 as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Now we have to see the pairs. And if you see, we have one pair of 2. So 1 2 will come out. We have one more pair of 2. One more 2 will come out. And the answer is 4. I hope you are able to understand this thing. No, beta Ashmit, not HCF. It is prime factorization. Okay. Now tell me this answer. If I give you a question, find square root of 64. Class, find square root of 64 by the same way, prime factorization. Very good, Naina. Find the root of 64 by prime factorization. Again, you can solve 2, 3s are, 2s are, 8s are, 4s are, 2s are, 1s are. So we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 2s. So we can write, we want to find this thing. It can be written as, now the question comes, what will come out? Acha, Lavya is asking, sir, square root, why power change from 2 to 1 by 2? Class, this is just a name. If power is 2, we say, let me show you one thing. So if power is integer, like simple 2, we say it is a square. If power is 3, we say it is a cube. Similarly, we have power 4, power 5, power 6, power 7, power 8, and so on. But if power is 1 by 2, class, if power is 1 by 2, we call it square root. If power is 1 by 3, we call it cube root. Similarly, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6, and so on. In your course, only you have to deal with these two. What are squares and what are square roots? That's it. Okay. So this is a square root. Okay. Under root 64. Rachit saying once more, better it is not a dance performance. Let's see. Let's see. If you say 8 square is 64, class, we say this thing, 8 square is 64. If you take this power 2 to that side, if you take this power to that side, it becomes 8 is equal to 64 power 1 upon 2. They both are same thing, class. Similarly, if I say 4 square is 16, so 4 is equal to how much? 16 power 1 by 2. So when power transposes, it becomes in fraction. Okay. Why? Beta, it is a rule. As we have seen, whatever is being added on left side, it becomes minus on right side. Whatever multiplied on left side was dividing on right side. Similarly, if the power is in normal terms, it becomes fraction on other side. Okay. This is known as the concept of square and square root. Okay. So square root is reverse of square. That's it. Let's see some more examples. Let's see some more examples. So we have got 64 like this. Now let's see how many pairs are there. First pair, 1, 2 will come out. Second pair, second 2 will come out. Third pair, third 2 will come out. And the answer is 8. No, but not 3. Answer is 8. We have 2, 2, 2. Let's take one more example. Try to find square root of 144. Or you can write like this also. They both are same thing. If you write power as 1 by 2 or you make this home, they are the same thing. Ashmit, but try to understand. We have to find square root of 144. Yes, Tushita, Rishi, good. Try to find by prime factorization. We have got 144 I hope you have seen the video before. If you have seen the video, it will be easy for you. I have uploaded the video day before yesterday. So you can write this 144 as square root 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Now we will see what will come out. We have a pair of 2. So 1, 2 will come out. We have second pair of 2, 1, 2 will come out. We have a pair of 3, what will come out? Class, please answer. 3 will come out. So the answer is 2 to the 4, 4 3 is a 12. That is how I got this. Okay, let me give you one more example. Let us take one more example. Suppose... Yes, beta. I've told you, na? They are in pair. You have to be in pair to come out as single. Please show the first example. This one. Solve one more example, please, beta. Class, please take root 121. Tell me what is answer of root 121. Please tell me the example of, sorry, answer of root 121. Very simple. We can write 121 in prime factorization as 11 11s are 121, 11 ones are 11. So let's write this in this way, square root 11 into 11. Now class, we have a pair of 11. What will come out? Simply 111 will come out as the answer. This is rule of square root. If you have two numbers same to same, one will come out. This is rule of square root. Now let's see Pythagoras theorem. So class, if you have a right angle triangle, if you have a right angle triangle ABC, can you tell me which angle is 90 degree? Class, can you please tell me which angle is 90 degree? Yes, this symbol signifies that this angle is 90 degree and hence the triangle is a right angle triangle. Can you tell me which side is hypotenuse in this triangle ABC? Which side is hypotenuse or the longest side? Hypotenuse, very good everyone. Hypotenuse is a side which is equal to the right angle, which is AC. This is your hypotenuse or the longest side. Now, in the video also I've told you, you can take this as perpendicular and this as base, or if you want, you can take reverse also. That is also possible. Class, hypotenuse is fixed. It is always opposite to right angle, but perpendicular and base can interchange as per the requirement. Okay? Yes, beta. You can take AB as perpendicular or you can take BC as perpendicular. It is okay. But the hypotenuse is confirmed. Okay? Now, tell me what is Pythagoras' theorem. Pythagoras said, if you know two sides of a triangle, you can easily find third side with the help of my theorem that says hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. So he said, if a triangle follows this relation, that triangle is always right angle triangle. So Pythagoras said, if a triangle follows this relation, that triangle is a right angle triangle. Very good, Jitesh. Beta Ryan, I didn't understand will not help anything. You have to try. In this question, you have three sides, one hypotenuse, one perpendicular, one base. You have a relation. That's it. What is there to understand? Sir, if base and perpendicular are not equal, then also we can change. Yes, beta, then also you can change. Rachit, no issue. Okay. There is no issue. Ha, beta, I'm giving examples. Let's take. Let us take question 1 of 6.5. Exercise 6.5, question 1. PQR is a triangle right angled at P. So diagram I have to make first. This is the diagram. They are saying right angle is at P. So we have to make this angle as P, this as Q, and this as R. This RQ can interchange, no issue. But this P is fixed. It should be a right angle. Now, they are saying if PQ is 10 centimeter, if PQ equal to 10 centimeter and PR equal to 24 centimeter, find QR. Class, very easy. What is QR? QR is the hypotenuse. What is PR? Let's take it as base, no issue. Let's take this PQ as perpendicular and use Pythagoras theorem. Class, we can say this QR is hypotenuse, therefore QR square is equal to PQ square plus PR square. Let's put the values. The value of PQ is how much? 10 in bracket whole power 2 plus the value of PR is 24 power 2. Till this point, is it clear to everyone what I have done? Class, till this point, is it clear to you? Please confirm. I have just put the values in Pythagoras theorem. Okay. Now tell me, what is value of 10 square? Class, tell me, what is the value of 10 square? Is it 20? Class, is it 20? Thank you everyone, it is 100. 10 tens are 100. And what is the answer of 24 square? Please find it fast. What is the answer of 24 square? Class, please answer. Please answer. It is 576. Yes. If you add them, what will you get? 676. Now, tell me, I want QR or QR square? Class, I need QR or QR square. What is the question asking? What is the question asking? Yes, it is asking QR. So I have to take this power 2 to the right hand side class, I have to take this power 2 to the right hand side. It becomes how much? This power 2 will become how much? We will transpose power 2, it becomes half on that side. So we will have 676 power 1/2, or we can write this as this thing also. They both are same. You write like this or write like this, they are same. Now tell me, what is square root of 676? Tell me, what is square root of 676? Very good, Lavya. Very good. 2 3 are 6. 2 3 are 6. 2 8 are 16. 2 1s are 2 6s are 2 9s are 13 13s are 169, and 13 1s are this thing. So we have done prime factorization, and I've written the answer as 2 into 2 into 13 into 13. Now the question comes, who will come out? Who will come out of this jail? This is a like a jail. Square root is a jail, and the rule of jail is those people who are in pair can come out as single. So 2 will come outside and 1 13 will come outside, and the answer is 26 centimeter. So we have got the length of QR as 26 centimeter. I hope it is clear to everyone. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now I will see how this thing is applied in our daily life. Okay, you all have a question in your mind that, sir, where do we use all these things? For that, there is a question which will help you to understand the application of Pythagoras theorem. Question number 3. This is an application in real life. Suppose you have a ladder, a 15 meter long ladder reached a window 12 meter high. So you have a case like this. Let me draw. This is a real life application of right angle triangle. Okay. So we have a 15 meter long ladder. So ladder length is given to you, 15 meter. The window height is 12 meter high. So suppose here is your window. Let me call it A, B, C. We all know the window is always at a perpendicular. The wall are always perpendicular to the base. So this is given to you as 12 meter. This is given to you as length of ladder AC is equal to 15 meter. Now what they are asking? They are asking, find the distance of foot of the ladder from the wall. So we have to find this thing. Class, can you find this? We just have a ladder that we have put on the wall. It is acting as a hypotenuse. The ladder is acting as a hypotenuse. The wall is acting as a perpendicular, and we want to find the length of base. Very simple. Just put the formula, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. The value of AC is given to us 15. Value of AB is given to us 12. And BC is unknown. Now, what shall we do? First, tell me what is 15 square. Class, tell me what is 15 square. You can understand now how Pythagoras helped us to find the third side. It is 225. Very good. 225. What is 12 square? Class, what is 12 square? The formula is hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. That's it. 12 square is 144 plus BC square. Now we have learned in chapter number 4, whatever you want to find, first you need to isolate it. And to isolate it, we have to take this 144 to the left hand side. It becomes BC square is equal to 225 minus 144. Tell me the answer. Class, tell me the answer of subtraction. 5 minus 4 is 1. Class, tell me the answer. It is 81 equal to BC square. Now we want BC. We don't want BC square. So what will we do? We will take this power to the right, to the left hand side. It becomes BC is equal to 81 power 1 upon 2. Yes, beta, you can reconnect, no issue. So what will we get? Tell me the answer of root 81. Class, what is the answer of root 81? Very simple. 327s are, 3 9s are, 3 3s are, and 3 1s are. So we can write this as, one 3 will come out, and second 3 will come out, and the answer is 9 centimeter. So the ladder is kept at a distance of 9 centimeter from the wall. I hope you are able to understand the question. Daksh saying the sums are very easy but time consuming. Beta, time is for utilizing only, na? You are utilizing your time here. So let me finish it over here. We will try in the next class now.